Last time we talked about power series, radii of convergences of convergence, and intervals of convergence. This time we're going to talk about how you actually go about computing radii of convergence and interval of convergence. And our big guns are the root and the ratio test, especially the ratio tests. Root test comes in occasionally. I find that the ratio test is actually the more useful. The point is that if you apply the ratio test to a power series, you're taking the limit of an to plus 1x to the n plus 1 over an x to the n. And all of the factors of x cancel except for 1, and that just pulls out. So you really are just looking at the size of x times the limit of an plus 1 over an. So if you can figure out this limit, you're golden. Likewise, if you apply the root test, if you take the nth root of an x to the n, well, the nth root of x to the n is just x. And the nth root of an, well, that's what you would study with the root test. So the rule is that if you get a number by either of the two tests, and if you get the number by one test, you're going to get the same number by the other test. So if you get a number, let's call it L, which is the limit of the ratio of coefficients, or L is the limit of the nth root of the nth coefficient. If that happens, then that gives you the radius of convergence. If L is 0, then the radius of convergence is infinity, because if this limit goes to 0, then no matter how big X is, this whole thing goes to 0, and therefore the series converges. If L is infinite, then the radius of convergence is 0. Because no matter how small x is, this whole thing blows up, and so the series diverges. If L is a finite number, then the radius of convergence is its reciprocal. Because as long as the magnitude of x is less than 1 over L, then this is going to be less than 1. If the magnitude of x is bigger than 1 over L, then this is going to be bigger than 1. And if the magnitude of x is equal to 1 over L, well, then you have to worry about those special cases by hand. Finally, sometimes you have a situation where L doesn't exist. You apply the root test or the ratio test, and you just don't get a consistent answer, in which case, oh well, it didn't work. Try something else. So let's look at some examples. Our first example is a sum of n cubed x to the n. In this example, an is n cubed. And we compute by the ratio test the limit of an plus 1 over an. It's the limit of n plus 1 cubed over n cubed. N plus 1 over n goes to 1, so its cube goes to 1. Since L is 1, R is the reciprocal of 1, which is 1. So the series diverges when x is bigger than 1. It converges when x is less than 1. And we have to check the cases where x is 1 or minus 1 by hand. When x is 1, we have just the sum of n cubed. Well, that diverges because the terms get big. When x is minus 1, you have plus or minus n cubed. That also diverges. So in this case, the series diverges when it's on the borderline. So the interval of convergence is an interval of radius 1, but that doesn't include the endpoints. Our next example is the sum of n factorial times x to the n. So an is n factorial, L is the limit of n plus 1 factorial over n factorial, and that's n plus 1, and that goes to infinity, so the radius of convergence is 0. The only value of x for which this converges is x equals 0, in which case all the terms but the zeroth term are 0, so of course it converges. The next example is the sum of x to the n over n factorial. Now, L is the limit of 1 over n plus 1 factorial divided by 1 over n factorial. In other words, n factorial divided by n plus 1 factorial. That's 1 over n plus 1. That goes to 0. So that means the radius of convergence is infinite. And the interval of convergence is everything. No matter how big x is, this series converges. And finally, let's look at the sum of x to the n over n. Now we take L as the limit of 1 over n plus 1 divided by 1 over n. That limit is 1, so our radius of convergence is 1. We look at what happens in the boundary when x is minus 1. This converges. It's an alternating series. When x is plus 1, it diverges. So that means that the interval of convergence is from minus 1 to 1, including minus 1, but not including 1.